Hi Scorpio, how are you guys doing? I'm so sorry for not posting your videos for the past 2 days, as I was so swamped with personal reading. But I am here now and I'm so excited to do your daily guidance reading for you. I have missed you guys so much, believe it or not. But today is the 14th of June 2020. And let's check with the spirits and angels, important messages of advice and guidance for you. And Scorpio, thank you so much for subscribing to my channel. I really appreciate your love and support. Okay, let's get to your reading, Scorpio. Spirits and angels, please show me accurate advice and guidance messages for Scorpio. I'm not taking these. No. This one has to come out so badly. Okay, Lover's card in reverse. Empress. Scorpio, 14 June 2020. Advice and guidance. This one's to come out. Scorpio. Quick one. I was shuffling just now, and the before I did this reading, and the Knight of Cups actually came out, so it has appeared again. Whoa. Okay. Let's take this Page of Cups. Bottom of the deck is the Knight of Pentacles. This is interesting. Okay, with the Lover's card in reverse, I feel like there was probably an ending in a relationship, and some secrets have come out, some revelation with the High Priestess in reverse. But I feel like Spirit is saying that with this three, the Knight of Pentacles, the Knight of Cups, Page of Cups. What I'm seeing is not really three different person. I'm sensing it's not about a person, okay? Although there are two knights and one page here, I see more of some sort of an apology, some offering. And it's almost like the universe is trying to say, spirit's trying to say that, what are you waiting for? If this is not you, this is the other person's energy, okay? Something about, I feel this very pressing message of urgency for some reason. Why are you still so confused? Why are you so still so confused? It's like time to offer. If you want to offer something to someone, or if you want to speak to them, apologize to them, whatever the case is, I really don't see this as three different individuals, okay? It's just my own opinion, my own taking on these cards intuitively. I feel like the universe is trying to show you, to tell you, asking you, what are you waiting for? I just keep getting that. What are you waiting for? Look, Seven of Pentacles here. What are you waiting for? No wonder you don't see results. No wonder nothing is happening, or very little is happening, because it seems like you are waiting for, like, it's just this sense of urgency for some reason. The moment I saw these three cards here, I was like, no, it's not about a person. I feel like the message is more about someone, whoever in this connection, or what this could be, love, career, whatever situation you're going through right now, you just apply to it accordingly, okay? Because it is a general message. But I strongly feel like if there is an apology in order, it's time to do it. Spirit is saying, what are you waiting for? Okay, with the Seven Pentacles, no wonder you don't see results. If you don't take action, you know, if you need to offer something to someone, it's time to do it. It's like there is so much delaying because of uncertainties, confusion, delusional, and illusion. It's almost like, you know, someone's head or mind is all over the place and can't make up their mind. It's like I'm sensing it has become such a blur. It's like everything. It's almost like you can't even pick out what is what anymore. You know, it's like everything is mushed together. That's what I'm seeing. And if there is someone you need to say sorry to, or this person, whoever, who needs to say sorry to you or offer you something, they better do it now. I feel like they better do it now, and they better do it with some creativity. If you have been in whoever, okay, it doesn't really matter. I'm not like just saying it's you, it could be the other person. But there is an Empress card here. So Empress card, you could be dealing with a Libra, a Taurus, could be a Virgo as well. It doesn't really matter the signs. Don't take it too seriously. But I feel like Spirit is saying if you have something to tell someone, something to offer to someone, an apology or whatever the case is, do it with creativity. Do it differently from how you used to do it. Sometimes I'm just sensing, like, sometimes, you know, it's like if this is like a sort of a situation where it keeps happening over and over again, you know, like a couple will fight and then they, or friends, even friendship, could be friendship, family, but people will fight and then they will argue and then they will say they're sorry, and then they keep repeating the same pattern, like fight, sorry, fight, sorry. So it became like sort of a repetition. And by the 10th time of saying you are sorry, or they are saying to you that they are sorry, then it's like it doesn't do anything anymore because it's the same old, same old. So I feel like if this person, if you are the one who has to apologize to someone, or if someone needs to apologize to you, they better come in a way that is completely different from how they used to do it. Possibly like offering you something. I wouldn't say it's material because I mean, but I do see it as material. Normally with the Page of Cups, you know, it's cups, it's emotions and love, but page is small. But with a little fish here, I feel like someone has to come in with an apology or offering that is different from how it used to be, something a bit more creative. It could be something material, but something creative. I'm sensing like possibly a written note, okay, a card. And on top of that, there is the Knight of Cups here. Knight of Cups, I feel like it has to come from your heart or from their heart. Roles can be reversed. So, or also very romantic. Okay, now I'm getting it. So it's like writing something romantic on a piece of paper or on a card, okay, how you truly feel for this person in a very romantic, creative way. I feel like nowadays, not many people, everybody is texting, everybody is emailing, you know, no one is actually writing things down on paper or writing notes. I feel it's quite rare nowadays. Like everyone's just be texting using electronics. Even when they send cards, it's like electronic cards, you know, digital cards. Invitation is mostly digital as well. But I feel like if someone needs to come to you to apologize to you, or if it's vice versa, it has to be something that is very creative and heartfelt and romantic. And I don't know why, I'm just seeing like writing down your thoughts, what how you feel, express it in paper, in writing. That's what I'm getting from this reading. And that's the Empress here. That's someone I feel like, if this is you, then this person must love you so much, and they really see long-term commitment. They see you as so beautiful, luscious, wife material. Could be the mother of your children. So there is a lot of love here, but there was an ending because something has come out here, okay, with the High Priestess in reverse. Something has come out. Someone has probably made a choice, but I feel like the choice was a wrong choice, okay? It was a wrong choice. Did something, I feel like, because the Lover's card is also about choice, but it could also mean third party situation, may or may not, okay? Take what resonates with you, but definitely I see there was an ending because somebody made a wrong, there was an ending because somebody took the wrong step or made the wrong choice. Could be choice between two people or choice between two different things or however you apply it, because this is a general reading. But the High Priestess is in reverse, so it's like it has become more than ever clear that the choice whoever has made in this connection was sort of wrong, and now it's time to be clear about it. I also am sensing someone here is thinking, someone is thinking of different ways, confused with different, how should I approach this? It's almost like just three different approaches that everyone, it's almost like should I approach him or her with as a Knight of Pentacles, or should I approach him or her with the Knight of Cups, or should I approach him or her with as a Page of Cups? What should I do? What should I do? So this is what I am sensing. excuse me. Sorry, I coughed. So because I'm like really excited, and here's the Seven of Cups. I really missed you guys. I really miss reading for you guys every single day, and just this morning I was like, oh my gosh, I really have to do it. Just having this sense of like excitement and missing you guys. But anyway, let's get back to it. So here's the Seven of Cups here. I feel like this message for you today, it's more so like someone in this connection, it could be you or the other person, okay? Someone is trying to figure out a way to approach you, to offer you something. It could be like, should I approach him or her slowly and steadily with something of a material stuff that could be of value, or should I approach them with by romanticizing them, like being romantic, being like a Romeo? To me, Knight of Cups is a Romeo, although many readers read it as the knight in the shining armor, but I feel more like someone who is very like a Romeo. Should I like approach them and instead and tell them how much I love them and blah blah blah, or should I approach them with something different, out of the ordinary, out of the like compared to the past or whatever that has been done within this connection? Should I approach them with something more creative? So this is, I feel, is the confusion. If this is you, then you could be confused. But if this is you also, the universe trying to say that make a choice. It's like, make a choice, okay? Make a choice how you want to approach this person. Do not wait anymore, okay? Do not wait anymore, because else this person is really gonna get even more upset with you. And because with the King of Swords, it's in reverse, someone is angry. If this is you, then you get even more upset if they make you wait for so long, That's what I'm getting. It's like if they make you wait for so long, you're gonna get really, really upset. But if you're making the other person wait so long, they will get really upset. So it's in reverse. So on top of that, there's this vindictive energy as well, I feel like, yeah, this is the Hermit card. This is an air sign. But you're a Scorpio. I feel like you are more like here, the Page of Cups and the Knight of Cups. But it doesn't matter. Don't get too hung up with the horoscope. I mean, with the signs. Sorry. I'm just looking at this. I'm like getting so excited. But yep. So Spirit is saying, if you're the one who is going, if you're the one who wants to like offer something to someone, apology or whatever the case is after I feel like it was a breakup, don't be confused. The universe is saying, don't be confused. Pick something, you know, whatever it is, just approach, just go ahead and do not wait anymore, because the longer you wait, the angrier the other person is gonna get, the more they are really going to seriously cut you off. Cut you off. Could be communication as well, and maybe they haven't been replying, but then now they're like going to completely block you or something. Okay, so and the Hermit mode is right here. Like you're like, there's a lot of thinking here, right? So waiting, thinking, confused. Like all of these three cards is like, to me, it's like waiting. They are very slow cards. That is like sort of idle, I feel. Okay, a lot of things going on in your head or in their head. A lot of things are going on in their head, but there's no action. So Spirit is saying, time to take actions. Whichever you're gonna choose that you see fit, you should just approach. If this is you, or the other person should approach you ASAP, and you know, choose their method or ways of approaching you and just do it. If not, they're going to risk you angrier and risk the breakup. You know, the ending, if this is about career, it's like if you need to take actions, you need to do something, you know, don't be confused, like just do it, and else you're gonna lose the money. Okay, this could also cause, if this is a love situation, it could cause losing your family too, you know? So it's time to be the emperor. Take charge, you know, take charge, plan and stick to it and just go, do it. Just go do it. That's the message I'm getting for today. For you, Scorpio. I love you guys so much. And I really, really did miss you guys. And thank you so much for liking, sharing, and subscribing to my channel. And I also do private reading. My number is in the description box below if you would like to book me for a personal reading. And yeah, I'm going to do my best to post your videos every single day, but there are some days that I won't be able to, so please forgive me. I hope to see you tomorrow, Scorpio. Bye.